Which laser wavelengths are safe for dark skin? I am Middle Eastern and was recently told by an aesthetician that the YAG 1064 is the only wavelength safe for darker skin tones. I am considering several laser treatments, including the Halo, Infiniti, Vivace, and the Genesis. My primary areas of concern are skin texture, large pores, and fine lines under the eye area and between the brows. Genesis seems to be the only laser with a 1064 wavelength. However, it seems to be used primarily for redness and hyperpigmentation.
Thank you for your question. You submitted your question without a photo, and essentially you are describing your discussion with an aesthetician who said that because of your Middle Eastern background, that the 1064 YAG laser is the only wavelength safe for your skin type and for darker skin. And your primary concerns is to improve the pores, the fine lines under the eyes, and the lines in between the eyebrows. And so you've listed several names of different brands, and you found that one particular brand mainly helps pigmentation and redness. Well, I can certainly understand why this can be a little overwhelming based on that one particular idea that was presented to you by the aesthetician. And I can certainly share with you how I discuss these issues with my patients. A little bit of background, I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial, plastic, and reconstructive surgeon. I've been in practice in Manhattan and Long Island for over 20 years. In our practice, we offer everything from non-surgical procedures, such as hydrofacial and multiple different lasers, as well as advanced surgical procedures, such as a lower eyelid blepharoplasty, eyelid surgery, facelifting surgery, etc. So it is certainly important for any practitioner to recognize the importance of selecting the right wavelength or the right laser procedure for the right patient. But I think that it is understandable why you're a little bit overwhelmed and you're looking at the information often provided by manufacturers about the things that are good for light or dark skin. And I can tell you from decades of using lasers and different devices that many lasers can be used for dark skin. It has to do with something called the relative absorption of particular wavelengths to melanin. And so your aesthetician is somewhat appropriately counseling you in that 1064 YAG is safer for darker skin types because of that wavelength selectivity. However, the differences between lasers are too many to describe, and there are certain technologies that have been used of different wavelengths that can also be used on darker skin. So it is less about the laser than it is about the doctor who is selecting the laser. And also, you don't need to just limit yourself when it comes to these treatments by just laser alone. For example, if you want to improve the appearance of pores or dilated pores, well, you can use a combination approach. For pores, we've used something called 1064 YAG Q-switch laser to help reduce pores. You can also use a technique of using Botox or a neuromodulator injection or the delivery through a microneedling device to improve the appearance of pores. And this is well documented, and I always believe in synergistic approaches, so I'll often combine two different modalities together. When you talk about fine lines under the eyes, there is actually a particular method using an erbium laser, but that is minimally ablative. And in one of our lasers, we can actually use that in a way to stimulate the collagen and improve the skin quality without getting the classic ablation, which means removal of skin, with that same wavelength. So the wavelength is one part of the equation. The other part has to do with the longevity of that delivery of that pulse, as well as the energy delivered. And these are technical issues, and certainly not necessarily important for you to fully understand. But when you think of these variables, you can realize that there's a lot of ways to adjust these variables to maximize the safety. When it comes to any darker skin type, you can be sure that the biggest concern is too much getting a reaction which results in too much pigment, or a result where you lose pigment. So most of the times these treatments have to be adjusted. In addition, when it comes to fine lines under the eyes, we have had a lot of success using something like platelet-rich plasma, PRP. We can also combine that with a neuromodulator and improve the fine lines. For the lines between the brows, essentially Botox or any other neuromodulator is likely to be a value, as well as an injectable filler, something in the hyaluronic acid family. So I think that one of the things that you might be getting is a little bit of a bias, because if it's an aesthetician who is advising you, well, they're only advising you about a laser, and they may be only legally limited to only be able to use a laser. But if you were to go to a physician, you might find that you'll get more options, which will be more appropriately customized for your issues. The goal is to get the best treatment, and you really ought not to be limited. So you may want to consider combining different modalities. There are also ways to help improve pores with hydrofacial or microdermabrasion. So obviously you are on the right path in asking about lasers, but a laser is only as good as the practitioner who uses that laser and how that practitioner customizes that treatment. It is certainly true that lasers that are more recently developed over the past several years have a lot of intrinsic safety measures placed, where you can literally plug in or enter the person's skin type and what their problem is and get a range of parameters. But an experienced physician will also have the experience from doing the previous treatments and the understanding of the skin to help customize that. And I think that is a value there. So I think it's worthwhile pursuing that approach. So meet with a qualified, experienced physician who offers all these different types of treatments, and get a sense of what their experience is and what their bias is. But certainly understand that anything for skin is often a treatment strategy which requires multiple treatments as well as some maintenance treatments. And that's a very important thing to understand going in, so that you don't have disproportionate expectations after one treatment. But I think that you are on the right path. I think it's certainly overwhelming, and that's why having an experienced professional guide you will probably take you to the next step moving forward. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for your question.